remark that this is the first of several concerts that will take place here in this church, sometimes outside, sometimes if we need to, we'll be inside. We also will be presenting two performances at the First Presbyterian Church in Hartford. I would like to invite you to those as well. The program includes all of those descriptions. This festival is accompanying a summer music institute, and this year we are delighted to have four departments, really, four areas of studies. We have quite a beautiful vocal department. We have young strings, which is basically string orchestra, piano, which Nathaniel Baker is one of the faculty, and Jūratė is heading the vocal, of course. And we have jazz with Alex Nakimovsky. So if you come, if you want to hear some great music, this is your place, this is your time. So again, welcome to the 2021 festival and enjoy the program.
Heard Morgen tomorrow by Richard Strauss. And now I will sing two other pieces by Strauss. He left a treasure trove of music, but he also was very known for his art songs. These particular two art songs, Die Nacht and Zueignung, the Night and Dedication, were part of the first art songs that were published. Die Nacht. night comes over and envelops everything. It steals the silver from the streams, it steals the copper from the domes, and I'm afraid that it will steal you too.
Thank you.
from his opera, I Lituani. Not everybody knows that Ponchielli has written other operas other than Gioconda. He's written quite a few, and I Lituani is one of them. It was written and premiered in 1874. It was very timely because as Italy was struggling for its independence, the plot of this opera and the plot of the drama that opera was written upon is also a struggle for its independence and for its freedom from crusaders, from Teutonic Knights, and it's a struggle by the nation of Lithuania. A famous Polish dramaturg and poet who is also being held native to Lithuania as well as Poland, Adam Mickiewicz, has written his drama, Konrad, or not drama, but a versed poem, versed book, Konrad Wallenrod, that was based on a number of actual historic figures. But it was each character was a compilation of number of historic figures, and it depicts the Lithuanian struggle for its independence and primarily the crushing of the Teutonic Knights, which the Poland and Lithuania has a history of being the same country for centuries. Also has a history of struggling against the Teutonic Knights, and Lithuanian, very often Polish king and Lithuanian king were the same person, and they were related to Lithuanian grand dukes and vice versa, so the countries are very much neighboring. At that time, this is a historic fact, at that time Polish king was a cousin to a Lithuanian grand duke, and they couldn't agree among themselves how they're going to resolve the issue of the crusaders. And so the Polish king wanted to take the road of diplomacy. Lithuanian duke was more of a muscle guy and more guns and cannons type of guy. Well, not guns at that time, bows and arrows, but cannons, still cannons at that time. And so he persuaded his cousin that it needs to be resolved in not such a peaceful manner. But Lithuanian grand duke went and signed a treaty with crusaders, a temporarily peace treaty, also borrowed money from him. Little did crusaders know that with that borrowed money, Lithuanian grand duke went and hired a mercenary army in the neighboring Slavic countries. And so the armies of Poland, Lithuania, and the mercenary armies of the neighboring countries have crushed the Teutonic Knights, and that was the end. So not also Teutonic Knights were crushed, but also that's a little known historic fact, but nevertheless it's a fact that whatever was left in the coffers, they had to pay restitution to Poland and Lithuania in the money of that time, 1 million gold coins. I don't know how much money it would be now, but I can't imagine a lot if back then, in 1400s, it was 1 million gold coins, so that's what it was. So the opera is based on the story, and the story, a personal story of a young man whose parents were killed by crusaders, and one of the crusaders took a young lad to raise as his own. Once he has grown, he went back to Lithuania because he was a noble, he married a princess, and since they didn't see the way out of the situation, he said, I am going to infiltrate the crusaders and bring them down from within. 10 years goes by, she goes looking for her husband. They have a fight, but she goes looking for her husband because she knows he must be still alive. Little does she know that he rose to the ranks of the chief. He was the head of the crusaders. He did end up bringing, in the opera, bringing the whole crusaders from within and crushing them because he was passing the information. But the aria that I will be singing is the aria where she enters the Marienburg, where was a seat of crusaders, and she sees all of this death and devastation and blood and gore, and she's just horrified, mortified, and she hopes that her husband is still alive, so that she doesn't know that he's still alive at that point. So there's Aldonas aria from Amilcare Ponchielli's I Lituani.
Come, Lugubre,
portion of the program and get a little bit of French. Duparc. Duparc didn't leave a lot of musical work alive. Some of it he has destroyed himself, and he didn't write a lot, but he wrote a beautiful, I don't want to say set, but a compilation of songs, 17 songs, that are quite lovely. What prevented him from creating more was a neurological and psychological disease. So he stopped creating, he focused on the family as much as he could. He has written an unfinished opera, and sources write that he has burned that work. He couldn't stand it and he burned that work. But here are two pieces that I absolutely love and love performing them. One of them is Extase, Ecstasy, and the other one is Chanson Triste, which is the sad song. So Extase, on a pale lily, my heart is sleeping. My heart is calm like death fragrant and death beautiful. On the pale chest, my heart is sleeping.
Thank you.
Nadia Boulanger. Nadia Boulanger was a great female figure in the music history. She was the first woman to conduct major orchestras. She was a teacher to some major composers like Aaron Copland, Virgil Thompson. She worked with Piazzolla, or maybe not worked, she turned him down and said that he should just pursue what he's doing because he's just fine. She was the teacher of Michel Legrand and many, many others. She was the mother of composers of the 20th century, basically. She was also a composer herself. And this is a piece called Cantique, the hymn. Is Dalia's aria from opera Dalia. It is a Lithuanian opera by Lithuanian composer Balys Dvarionas, and the aria is, she's a dancer. She has been taken to a foreign land, to a palace, and she misses her motherland. She misses her native town, which is Vilnius, where I'm from. And in this aria, she describes how beautiful the city is and how she misses walking on the shadows of steeples of the churches, and how these steeples seem like they have not been made by a calloused hands of workers, but as if they were made by a kind magician weaved out of dreams and hopes of people. How beautiful domes reflect in the sky. And so she wants to go, and she says, please let me go, I want to see, because my mother is still weeping for me and my father is still heartbroken. So, O ruler, please let me.
Oh,
go to two last pieces of the program, and it will be two my favorites and probably public favorites, Sure on the Shining Night, and Rusalka's Song to the Moon. So first, Sure on the Shining Night, which probably doesn't even need an introduction. By Antonin Dvorak. I mean, every nation, probably every culture, has their story about the Little Mermaid. Well, this is not an encyclopedia story, but I was named after a mermaid. My name in Lithuanian doesn't mean a mermaid, but it's a name of a mermaid, of a princess of the sea that lived in an amber palace, and her father, the Thunder, got angry at her that she fell in love with a mortal fisherman, and he sent a lightning bolt killing the fisherman and destroying the Amber Palace, and apparently that's why now amber washes ashore of Lithuania. So it has nothing to do with this Rusalka, but I love singing because it's such a beautiful, beautiful song and beautiful story of a mermaid trying to talk to the nature, to the moon, having light the way for